Wrestling fans, tonight's the second episode of MCW Riot Television, and where it should be an overjoyous occasion, and we're still showing you the main event of Brain Damage versus Necro Butcher. It actually is a very sad day for the family of MCW. 1 week ago today, I lost someone who was like my brother. The guys lost someone who was a brother to them in wrestling, as Brain Damage, born Marvin Lambert, passed away 1 week ago today. We ask you fans that tonight, when you watch a man who gave well close to 20 years of his body, his heart, everything he had to the world of professional wrestling, please take a moment to have thought for his family and those out there that are suffering during this time with the loss of one of the greatest men you could have ever met. Marvin, we love you, we miss you, and our hearts will forever be with you. I say this on behalf of the whole entire MCW family and the MCW fans. Thank you for your time. Good night.
Let the sparks fly.
MCW Riot Television, and it was a hell of an episode, man. We saw Justin May in a crazy three-way ladder match for the MCW Elite Championship, and we have a new MCW Elite Champion, your buddy, Patrick Hayes, no longer the champ. What do you think about that, Nick?
I'm disgusted. It's a travesty, Shasta, that man does not have the belt around his waist.
I'll tell you what, sometimes Patrick Hayes' eyes are way more on the prize, and that being the MCW Elite Championship. He had his eyes on Sarah Danielle just for a little bit. That few seconds cost him the belt, and there we have a new MCW Elite Champion. Folks, you saw it last week, fantastic ladder match, and this week's not gonna be any different because we've got a hell of a show. Before we get into that, we're gonna take a quick small break. We'll be right back here. Stay tuned in, because tonight you're gonna see on live TV something you have never saw on a pro wrestling show before. I will guarantee it. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. You got just a few seconds. Grab a drink, sit down, lock your seatbelts in, because it's gonna get crazy.
Tiptoe through the window,
Welcome back to MCW Riot Television. Shasta, I am still pissed. I cannot believe that Patrick Hayes got ripped off from his title.
Tell you what, Nick, I don't know about getting ripped off, but we do have a new MCW Elite Champion, that being Justin Mayne. This guy for the last year and a half has been oh so close. And that night, hey, he came through, but you know what? That's in the past. We're here to talk about the future. Tonight's episode of MCW Riot Television, we're bringing you the ladies of MCW. We've got the one and only, the world-renowned Jessica Havoc, one of the top female indie stars in all of wrestling, here at her home promotion of MCW. She's back home taking on the gorgeous Rebbie Sky. Rebbie Sky, the New York Giants girl, not bad on the eyes, somewhat of a newcomer to the wrestling scene. And we're going to take a look at Jessica Havoc and Rebbie Sky and see who comes out the best, Nick. You know what? We're going to go to that match right now, but I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, we told you before the first break that tonight we're going to go in the vault and bring you a match that you have never saw on professional wrestling television before, and that be a Fans Bring the Weapons match. We're digging deep into the vault, Nick, and bringing out that Fans Bring Weapons match, and we're going to see none other than from the movie The Wrestler, the Necro Butcher, taking on the Ultraviolet Terminator, Brain Damage. We've got MCW's own Brain Damage taking on Necro Butcher, and it's going to get crazy, Nick. But before we get into that, let's, you know, turn it back a few notches. Let's, you know, all you guys out there, you can't have a bad day looking at either one of these ladies.
Absolutely.
We're going to go to the ring now for some hard-hitting action with Rebbie Sky taking on Jessica Havoc. Let's go to that matchup.
All right, Matthew Priest, we are here at the 12th anniversary show at Marlington Middle School. Let's get the bell rung and let's get this ladies' match underway.
All right, Jessica Havoc here, longtime veteran at MCW, and she meets Rebbie Sky. Rebbie Sky's done a lot of work with Lucha Libre USA on MTV. I understand she's definitely been around the sport for a little bit. Not as experienced as Jessica Havoc, but she has that big time experience that could come into play here tonight. We'll find out. And Rebbie with a big forearm. Right out of a handful of them and locks on a nice side headlock.
I'm sorry, Matthew Priest, if I sound a little distracted. I am. Right now, it's kind of hard to concentrate on anything else but what's going on in that ring.
Jessica fires Sky in, looks for a shoulder block. Jessica just too big, too strong. Definitely has a size advantage as well as Jessica. And a kick to the midsection.
Jessica Havoc just brutally vicious.
She's got her up over her shoulder here. What's Jessica Havoc going to do? Rebbie Sky out the back door. Nice job by Sky there to pull it off. Using the momentum to her advantage there, she pulls Jessica down, and Jessica met her coming in with a big clothesline.
Jessica almost took her head off. My God.
Nice kick to the back there by Havoc, and Rebbie Sky. Not sure if she was prepared for the strength that Jessica Havoc possesses. Jessica tough as nails. Rebbie Sky's got a lot to prove here in MCW, making her MCW debut here against Jessica Havoc. Hard kick right across the midsection. Now Jessica putting the foot right on the throat there.
Jessica Havoc saying that she's the best, and she's got every right to that title, that's for sure. I haven't seen a female professional wrestler be so vicious.
Big kick, cross back area, cover one, two. It's only a two count. Now Jessica going back to a blatant chokehold. And she looks right into the referee's eyes while she was doing that. Almost taunting him to disqualify her.
She doesn't care about the rules. All she cares about is putting pain in her opponents.
And it's pretty hard to wrestle when you can't breathe, especially in this atmosphere here. Very thick, the humid atmosphere, very hard to catch your breath, and that could be why Jessica's implementing the strategy of going for different chokes and putting her throat across the ropes, and now you see her having a lot in here in a full Nelson hold, and this could do it, Nick. She's got this thing clamped in. She's got her surfboarded out. I don't know how Rebby's going to get out of this thing. This could be out right here. Justin's got that thing cinched in tight. Rebby, though, was able to work her legs down. And then Jessica just throws her to the mat. No respect. Come on.
Jessica Havoc just tearing her apart piece by piece, throwing her around like a rag doll.
Now standing right on her sternum is Jessica Havoc. Rebby Sky in trouble.
Hey, Rebby Sky in serious trouble here. She hasn't had a bit of offense.
No, and outside that opening minute, it's been all Jessica Havoc. Just backbreaker, and then now stretching her right across her knee right there. And now applying a stomach claw. There's so many nerves in your stomach with the paralyzing maneuver and applied correctly. Cover, one, two, only a two count.
Wow, the angry scream coming from the soul of Jessica Havoc.
Yeah, that's just the strategist for sure. Trying to take the air out of Rebby Sky, wear her down. You saw her go for the chokes earlier, and you saw her now stretching her body across the knee, trying to wear down the ribs, trying to wear down the muscles in the stomach that contract when you breathe in and out. But that body scissor, and there's a one count. Jessica now just kicking her off.
She's about to squeeze the life out of her, man.
You probably like that, didn't you, Nick?
I do. I love it all.
Now Jessica looking in. Rebby Sky. Oh, nice job to get up there with that flying head scissor. Down goes Jessica, but Rebby hit the mat hard. Might have knocked the air out of her. I mean, like I said, there's been a lot of damage done to the midsection and the trachea area and larynx of Rebby Sky, to where it may be very difficult for her to catch her breath, catch her wind, and Jessica just kicked her right across the side of the head.
Just absolutely brutal. I've used this line before for Jessica Havoc. Brutally vicious.
One, two, and that's only a two count. Jessica once again just violently snatching her up here by the throat. Those are the eyes of a crazy person when you look in the eyes of Jessica Havoc.
Oh yeah, she's definitely not all there. She's
sheer lunacy as she charges in. Rebby out of the way. Jessica sternum first into the buckle. Here comes Rebby in, using all of her size that she can muster up against Jessica Havoc, throwing all of her weight behind each one of these strikes, trying to take the fight out of her larger opponent. Jessica now really getting worn down here. The stronger of the two still hasn't been knocked off of her feet. Here comes Rebby charging in. And one more time coming out, using the bulldog there. Good momentum picked up, driving Havoc down. One, two. Did Rebby Sky pull off the victory here? No, sir, only a two count.
No, just the two. Rebby Sky finally showing a little bit of offense here.
Look at Jessica up now, setting her up. Front chancery, and Jessica just drives her right back into the corner and gives her an always hard forearm shiver of her own. And now Rebby Sky is set up. What does Jessica have in store for her here? Walking in. Rebby Sky with a block. And now a couple of big forearms right the side of the head of Havoc. Tornado DDT. Down goes Havoc. This could be it. This could be it, Nick.
Wow, how the hell did Rebby Sky pull it and get a cover right here?
Here it is. One, two, Rebby Sky. Only a two count. Jessica Havoc didn't get the shoulder up. Too much of a delay over the cover there. I think the beating that Sky's taken this far in the matchup is really starting to take its toll.
Jessica Havoc, I think, is just too much to handle for Rebby Sky.
Rebby Sky looking for a twist of fate there. Havoc shoved her off. And now Havoc with a shot right downstairs. And the referee has disqualified Jessica Havoc. There appears to be something in her hand that the referee saw.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match by disqualification, Rebby Sky!
Jessica Havoc was in control, and I think she might have used the foreign object there. I think she might have thought she wasn't gonna get caught when she used it, but the referee saw it clear as day, and I mean, she hit her right in the ribs with it. And you see Rebby is just now picking herself off the canvas. She gets the victory. But she might be the worst for wear after this one.
Yeah, it's definitely taken a lot out of Rebby Sky. Jessica Havoc running her mouth at the little kid in the front row. She don't care.
Tell you what, Nick, Rebby Sky may have won the match, but I don't know if she won the war. Jessica Havoc losing there to DQ, I don't think she cared. I think that Jessica Havoc said, hey, welcome to my world. Welcome to the big leagues, kid. I'm going to take you on an adventure. And she didn't care about winning or losing. Great matchup. Rebby Sky, you know, fairly new to the sport. You know, she's only got a few matches under her belt. She went in there with one of today's top indie women performers, and that being in Jessica Havoc. And you know, like I said, she won the matchup, but I don't know if she's gonna think that tomorrow morning when she wakes up.
No, Jessica Havoc makes a lot of women consider or reconsider being in professional wrestling, that's for sure.
Absolutely. I'll tell you what, guys, what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna go take a small, short commercial break. Don't forget, tonight coming up later, we have that Fans Bring the Weapons match as the Ultraviolet Terminator Brain Damage is taking on the Necro Butcher. We also have,
be good,
coming up after the break, Seth Allen, Shawn Blaze, former tag team partners, former tag team champions in their first matchup against each other. You know what? We're going to let the fans take a look at that. Things in this matchup, you know, sometimes in wrestling, injuries happen, injuries occur. And tonight is one of those nights, but wait until you see what Shawn Blaze does. Stay tuned, folks. We're going to be right back here in just a few moments, Nick, and we're going to finish up the rest of the show, right?
Absolutely.
All right, see you when we get back. Seth Allen, Shawn Blaze, former tag team champions, getting ready to go into action. First time ever, these two guys are facing off. We told you guys, sometimes in the world of professional wrestling, things go bad, things go wrong, injuries happen. Tonight you're about to see something like that go down. And you know what? I don't want to give the fans too much, but wait till you see what Shawn Blaze does. This man has took things way beyond the realms of what people call sports entertainment. And he took advantage of a man that may have cost him his career. You know, I'll tell you what, I'm not going to get too much further into it, Nick. We're going to go to that match right now live as former tag team champions now waiting to kill each other. Shawn Blaze, Seth Allen, let's go to the ring.
Nick Andrews, these guys were the best of friends. Their hatred now runs as deep as their blood boils. And Shawn Blaze and Seth Allen, I mean, as you saw there, the blood has already been spilled to Seth Allen, and you know he wants to return the favor to Blaze, and will he get his chance here tonight? This is the first time ever in these men's career that they'll meet one-on-one.
Shawn Blaze very angry since losing the tag team titles, blaming Seth Allen as the weak link.
Allen going after Blaze here in the early going. A little cat and mouse game by Blaze. He wants no part of Allen, it doesn't seem. We got ourselves a grudge match here, folks. Allen, Blaze, as I mentioned, first time ever meeting between these two former best friends. Shawn Blaze ended the relationship with a super kick, heard all around MCW, and I tell you what, this thing is quite a combustible element right here.
Shawn Blaze lifting the dead weight off of his shoulders.
And Allen gonna bring him in the hard way.
And going into singles competition, now trying to get some revenge on his former tag team partner.
Well, we'll see who the dead weight is after this one, Nick. This is one-on-one. Who was the better broski? Was it Allen? Was it Blaze? We'll find out here tonight. Allen up and over. And a drop kick scores right there for Seth Allen. That's textbook Allen right there, man. Allen now fires in Blaze hard.
This is going to end here tonight, Priest.
Hey, high elevated back body drop.
There's no way this could go on any longer than tonight. This is it between these two. I'll
tell you what, Allen looks fired up. He looks ready. He comes charging in with a big forearm shiver right across the jaw of Shawn Blaze. And now brings him out, clothesline, turns him inside out. Allen is fired up tonight, boy.
Well, Seth Allen's just getting warmed up. Smart, just get out of the way.
Tell you what there, Allen saw him moving. I don't know if he tried to adjust in midair and land on his feet.
He might have landed on his knee wrong or something. He might have
hyperextended his knee.
All right, they're calling for our staff here. Something going on with Seth Allen's knee.
Now Shawn Blaze slowly walking over. The referee checking out. Security's coming to check around.
The referee stopping the match for a minute here just to see if Seth Allen can continue in this matchup.
He might have hyperextended that thing, man, Nick. I tell you what, I've been around business for a few years. I've heard of guys who shattered their kneecaps by just landing wrong, coming off that middle rope. Everything that they do in this ring, guys, is real serious. That's why these are professional wrestlers. Don't try this at home. I mean, you can't say it enough, but man, I tell you what, Seth Allen might be really injured here. As I mentioned, I knew the guy. He was out of action for 18 months, and oh no, this is not good. This is not good right here.
A referee giving the sign that we're gonna need some medical attention out here. It's unfortunate. I really wanted to see the end of this. Man, this pisses me off.
Well, what's most important here is that Seth Allen's okay. I mean, like, it does not seem good. The referee has not called for the bell. This matchup has not been stopped. They're going to check on the knee here of Seth Allen.
Wait a minute. Seth Allen's going to check to see if he's all right, but
Allen's knee might be gone here, man. It's so tragic. Coming off that middle rope. Let's see it again, folks. Let's see a shot of it. Here comes Allen off the middle rope, and you see him land awkwardly. I mean, the stress that shot through the leg there up into the knee, I mean, he could have ruptured his patella. He could have torn ACL. I mean, we don't know at this point. I'm just speculating, and I got to think for the best here, but when he looks at things, he looks at this the worst.
Well, Shawn Blaze still going after him. Shawn Blaze just pissed off. This is his chance to get some revenge, and now Seth Allen is not even well enough to compete.
I can't believe the referee thought this continued, man. This is sick. This shows you how much Shawn Blaze hates Seth Allen. This is sick. Come on. The man couldn't even walk seconds ago. He can't even move, and Shawn Blaze is just going to try to make sure that knee is gone. That knee is damaged. You see Allen trying to turn him away. Blaze just drove it down.
Officially, this match has not been stopped. The bell has not been rung.
No, it hasn't. The referee might want to think about stopping this thing, though. Allen pulls himself to his feet. I think Allen's realizing he's in a fight, and Blaze just kicked his leg right out of his way.
I think Shawn Blaze is looking to end this right now. Shawn Blaze is looking to end Seth Allen's career.
Yeah, he's looking to end the career. He doesn't look like he's trying to win this thing. He wants to cripple and maim Seth Allen's leg for the remainder of his career. Come on, referee, get in there. The back of the hamstring and the tendons in the back of your knee there. That's what Allen just had ring right off the steel frame of that wrestling ring.
And as much as I believe in Shawn Blaze's talents, You know, I really wanted to see Seth Allen at 100%. I really wanted to see these guys go at it.
And Allen there coming out of nowhere with a drop kick, but I mean, that was just instinct, Nick. We've seen him do that earlier in the match. That was strictly instinct, and I mean, I think that might have hurt Allen more than it hurt Blaze. I think Blaze was caught off guard by it, though. He looks shocked that Allen was able to dig down deep, pull off that dropkick. But you notice Allen now has got to scrape himself back up to his feet. I don't know how the hell he's doing this, because it's sure will. This is sure hatred, sure determination. And Sean Blaze with a dropkick of his own right above the kneecap of Seth Allen.
Just picking apart Seth Allen. Sean Blaze is just all over him.
Now gonna rip the knee pad down, exposing the kneecap of Allen, and he drives it down to the canvas. Allen trying to fight back with right hand to the midsection. Knife edge chop, he's up to his feet, he's back down. I don't know how the hell Allen's doing this. And Blaze with one quick kick just ended that right there.
I'm surprised to see so much fight out of Seth Allen. Just still fighting his way out of this one.
Blaze looks to be looking for a Texas cold relief here, Nick.
Oh, Sean Blaze has got it now. It's over. It's got to be over right now.
He is sitting down on this thing deep. The amount of pressure on the knee of... And then he let it go. And that also puts a lot of pressure on the Achilles heel, which connects to the ACL, the tendon, your Achilles tendon affects your ACL. So that will do extreme damage to the knee. And that's what Blaze is looking to do here. He is just relentless on this left knee here of Seth Allen. I don't think that Seth Allen should be able to continue this match. Referee needs to stop this thing. I can't believe he's let it continue this long.
I can't believe it either. That knee exposed to Sean Blaze is taking the knee pad down.
I know this is a grudge match. I know these guys hate each other. I know Seth Allen would not want to lose in the first ever meeting between him and Sean Blaze due to a referee stoppage to an injured knee. But sometimes these guys' well-being is more important than wins and losses. And health is the most important thing. Up and over. What a counter by Allen. Sunset flip cover. 1-2. He got him.
He got him.
How the hell did he do it? He got him. What the hell? Nick Andrews, how did he do that? How did he pull that off?
I'm speechless. My jaw just hit the announce table, Matthew Priest.
I can't believe
what I just saw. Seth Allen just pulled this out of somewhere, and he got a victory over Sean Blaze.
What a win. It's a win. No. What the hell? No, come on. Sore loser. What a sore loser. Come on, no, not like this.
Sean Blaze looking to finish.
No, don't do it. Don't do it. No. Oh, God, Allen able to kick the chair off. Allen was able to kick the chair off on the referee. Instructing Blaze to get the hell out of here. Allen's, I think, got security now. Comes in to check on Allen. Look at that sinister grin on the face of Sean Blaze.
Wow, what a surprise. Seth Allen, injured, beaten, broken, knee, and we don't even know what kind of condition Seth Allen's in right now, but somehow, some way, Seth Allen pulled off one of the biggest victories in his career here at MCW for sure. I'm sure that winning those tag team championships are right up there, but for a man to pull off a victory, Nick, after suffering such a severe knee injury, Seth Allen could barely walk out of the ring and somehow came up victorious in this matchup.
Well, he just got lucky, Shasta. Now, Sean Blaze was there checking on him to make sure he was okay. You see what kind of a man that Sean Blaze is?
Are you crazy? What did you just watch? Sean Blaze was not checking on Seth Allen to see if he was okay. What in the hell are you on? You're absolutely out of your mind.
I saw it right there.
Sean Blaze,
right there in the footage.
He took advantage of a man who was injured, a man who was down. You know, the referee was calling for help from the back. Seth Allen, we thought Seth Allen was going out there on a stretcher. Instead, he went out there with his hand raised. And one of your boys, Sean Blaze, tried to take advantage of a situation that wasn't too well for Seth Allen at the time and ended up getting his shoulders pinned to the mat for the 1-2-3. And I can tell you right now, Seth Allen, victorious, Sean Blaze, extremely pissed.
Very much so, Shasta.
But I'll tell you what, injuries, that doesn't matter, because coming up next, after this break, we're bringing you the matchup that we told you about last week. For the first time that some of you, you don't have to run a DVD here at MCW Riot Television to see these type of matchups. We brought you one hell of a ladder match last week for the debut episode, and this week we went back into the vaults. For the 11-year MCW anniversary, the WrestlePlex was packed that night. Pandemonium, you could feel the electricity. And we brought you a Fans Bring Weapons match. Nick, tell the fans before we go to this break, what is a Fans Bring Weapons match? What does that consist of?
You could bring anything you want. If you're a fan in the audience, you could bring the kitchen sink, and literally people have brought the kitchen sink. People have bought baseball bats wrapped in barbed wire, knives, forks, sledgehammers, you name it, Shasta.
Anything you get your hands on, they check it at the front door, and you get to watch it get used during this hardcore matchup. No rules, false count anywhere. When we come back, right here at Riot Television, stay tuned for your night's main event as the Necro Butcher versus the Ultraviolet Terminator Brain Damage. Right back here at Riot Television when we come back.
Massillon's newest haunted attraction. Lynch Family Revival. Open Fridays and Saturdays in October. A new terror has arrived.
Tiptoe through the window, by the window, that is where I'll be. Come tiptoe through the tulips with me.
Let's move kids to another.
MCW Riot Television, and this is the most important part of the show because this is what I've been looking forward to for a long time. Shasta, this is the Fans Bring the Weapons matches. These matches are insane. If you've ever been to one, you know what it's about. Now, Shasta, there's a lot of people in the crowd that have been to these. You've actually been involved in a Fans Bring the Weapons match. What can the fans expect?
I'll tell you what, I've been in numerous Fans Bring Weapons matches, and I want to tell you right now, as a matter of fact, before I even get into anything else, if blood, if craziness, if carnage offends anyone, this would probably be the only time that we're ever going to tell you to tune out of MCW Riot Television, because tonight it's about to get crazy. And I can tell you right now, I had many battles, from Christian Vaughn to tag team matchups, you know, the list goes on and on of the matchups I've had, and the injuries.
Yeah, severe injuries, man.
Sure,
I've seen you over the years, man. A lot of bad injuries.
Yeah, I've had a major back injury. I had a major back surgery where I was paralyzed for a couple of months. Both of my knees have been scoped. My ankle's been broke 7 or 8 times. I still have to have a surgery on that now. And I'll tell you what, concussions, blood, you name it. This is one of the most violent matchups that you'll ever have in wrestling. The fans sit around. They hear about these matchups coming. When you hear about a Fans Bring the Weapons matches coming to your town, you've got a month to prepare. And these people create some of the craziest weapons you've ever saw. We've had baseball bats with 500 thumbtacks glued to them, opposite side. We've had, as a matter of fact, in tonight's matchup, I know that someone had taken a sheet of plywood and put 400 sharpened pencils facing the opposite direction. You know, not the eraser side up for sure, but I'll tell you what, I've been beaten, I've been battered, I've been bruised, and I can tell you right now, these men, no matter who wins or loses one of these matches, the next day, nobody's won. That's a fact. you're still getting wounds to stop bleeding all through the night. You're pulling thumbtacks out of the back of your head. There's several times where I sound like I had tap shoes on. My wrestling boots were covered in thumbtacks. You know, bleeding, broken bones, that's going to happen. This is a time when you can guarantee you're going to see the most carnage you ever saw before on a live pro wrestling show. When you see hardcore matchups in the past, even the
nothing like this.
Yeah, you know what? ECW would not do a fans bring weapons match. Would they do hardcore matches? Sure. The guys would pick and choose what they would bring out. We don't have a clue what's going to be around the ring. We're getting ready to show you that tonight as you see the ring engulfed in weapons galore as we bring you tonight's main event in the Fans Bring Weapons match. Let's go to that matchup now. And as I said before, if you're a little squeamish, now's the time to tune up.
There he is, Nick. And I'll tell you what, there's been a rumor for the last couple of years, ever since the movie The Wrestler came out, that Brain Damage was slotted to take that spot, to take that role, to face Mickey Rourke in the movie The Wrestler, but missed his flight, and therefore the Necro Butcher got that spot. So tonight, these two are going to be able to settle that score.
Oh, well, rumors are rumors. I don't know if that's true or not, but here we are. We're going to see what happens when these two just forces collide in the middle of an MCW ring.
Most definitely, the fans waiting for the Ultraviolet Terminator, Brain Damage, making a special appearance here tonight. And let me tell you what, these fans, they're the ones who supplied the weapons. You don't find that anywhere, and here he is, Nick. There he is, a huge, huge fan favorite here at MCW. This place, capacity crowd on its feet. They know they're about to see something special. The Necro Butcher's already got a weapon in his hand. Brain Damage making his rounds, telling those fans he's glad they're here tonight. We're about to get this underway. This place is rocking and rolling. Pandemonium's about to take place. Wait a minute, right off the bat, Necro Butcher stabbing Brain Damage right in the head with an object.
Oh, man, look at him go. The Necro Butcher just taking it to Brain Damage right now, just trying to peel his face off of his skull.
I'll tell you what, I didn't know exactly how long it was going to take until we saw blood. And I knew that we weren't going to see the most technical wrestling match tonight. But my Lord Jesus.
Here he goes with the sign.
Yep, there it comes, right across the forehead. You know someone has broken a crime tonight to even have a road construction sign at the WrestlePlex. These fans don't care. He's threatening to hit the referee right now. I don't know what good that'll do him if Earl Robinson gets knocked out.
He's just trying to just chew his face off.
Spitting his blood up into the air. Earl Robinson better stay back. Big knife edge chop there. That may be the closest thing we see to a wrestling move all night long.
Oh, here it goes.
Yeah, frisbee the metal pan into his midsection.
My God.
There goes a wooden chair. Big punch. Brain Damage now cutting him off. I think he almost broke his hand by hitting Brain Damage in that skull of his. It's known that his head is rock hard. Now here we go, fighting through the crowd. We're going to see if we can get a camera on the action. We're going to see if we can get a camera. Get a cameraman over. There we go. We've got his pulled back over to the action now. Another knife edge chop, Nick. As I told you, that may be the only type of wrestling maneuver we see tonight. Brain Damage stalking down, big kick to the midsection there. Necro Butcher, big knee lift, another knee lift, three knee lifts right to the face, and then big quarter kick right to the front face, Nick.
The faces of these people in the crowd have just hit all on the ground, man. Everybody's jaws just hit unbelievably here. The turmoil that we've seen just in the few minutes of this match.
I tell you what, right here, the fans are standing around. The action's being brought directly to them. Necro Butcher now picking up tonight's trash, and he just delivered it right into Brain Damage's face. They're at the back of the MCW WrestlePlex. Trash all over the floor, raked to the eyes, and Necro Butcher making his way back to the ring. I don't know how much of this match will even end up in the ring tonight.
No, I don't really think it's going to be in the ring much at all, Shasta.
These fighters are just taking it all over the MCW WrestlePlex with Brain Damage's head hitting off that post.
Well, I'll tell you what. These guys are actually wrestlers. They may be in a fight. But nevertheless, there's that. There's one of the weapons, the fans broke. You know, we've got over 250 sharp pencils right on a board. He's getting ready to shoot Brain Damage's head right into there. I'll tell you what, he was already busted open. If he hits him on this, he's going to get more piercings than he came into the arena with tonight. Oh, big miss there by Necro Butcher coming back with a forearm. Another knife edge chop. Another forearm. Punch, punch, punch. I'll tell you what, right into the pole. Right, another knife edge chop. These two are going crazy. The fans are staying back. Security's keeping them back.
Oh, my God.
Wow, did you hear that?
Just taking a shot to the head.
Did you hear that shot?
It just echoed in here, Shasta.
Right now, Brain Damage is bleeding profusely from the head. I think Necro Butcher's just been busted wide open himself. Both men now bleeding. Somebody may need that crutch later on tonight. Oh, goodness, that's not going to work now.
Somebody's going to need that crutch. Those poor kids in Alliance needing those school supplies. Those pencils have just got broken. Now they're going to have nightmares, Shasta. Oh, my
big headbutt. Let's take a listen to this. These guys are cracking heads like two rhinos. Once again, big headbutt. I'm telling you, for you fans that are watching on TV tonight, you don't understand. We can hear those headbutts. We can hear them echoing all the way through. I mean, that's how hard these guys are hitting each other. You know, these two men right here, as I told you before, we weren't going to see the greatest technical match on earth.
Oh, this is a technical, right? God, they're just still going at it. I can't believe it.
Headbutts, headbutts, multiple headbutts now by the Necro Butcher. Security's even getting out of the way. We're up against a pole. Oh, my goodness, back of the head. Three, four times with the back of the head into that steel pole. These fans are in awe here. Blood is pouring from Brain Damage's head. You fans, I'm telling you right now, you have no clue what it's like unless you're here live at an MCW show. He just shot a shopping cart right into his nuts. Brain Damage now tracking down Necro Butcher.
And this
Oh my God! Jeff Jarrett would be proud. He just imploded that guitar all over. We've got our first pinfall, too. That's not going to be enough, Nick.
No, not enough. Not enough. The Necro Butcher has to unleash some more punishment on Brain Damage for sure. These guys see in red. These guys, I would imagine, they think they're on Mars right now for as much red as they're seeing.
Tell you what, looks like we're getting our first action in, maybe back in the ring since the start of this match. Brain Damage has not even stepped foot into the ring yet. Necro Butcher now setting up a chair. I don't know what he's got planned here. Looks like he's going over there for another chair. Whatever this is, I can promise you this. One thing they're not going to be doing right now is sitting down doing study work with each other back to back. We've got a frying pan. This place is full of carnage right now, Nick Andrews.
This looks like an Alliance garage sale, Shasta. Look at this. Necro Butcher setting up shop right now.
One of those pans say, ouch, and I can bet you that's what's about to be felt. Two chairs set up in the ring here. Necro Butcher making his way back out to the floor. Brain Damage looking for something. Just takes it right across the back. I don't know what he was looking for, though. He was at the Walmart shopping cart. I don't know how that ended up here. There's more illegal objects here inside the WrestlePlex tonight than I can count. But Necro Butcher picking Brain Damage up, Nick. I don't know what's in store here.
Oh, his face is in store to hit the crowd. That's what it's going to do.
Wait a minute. Got him up for a sidewalk slam. No, no, don't do it. He'll break him in half. Oh, my God. I cannot believe it. He just dropped him across. That's got to be it. That's
got to
be it. One, two, almost three. Brain Damage somehow kicking out. I thought that was it. He broke him across those chairs.
Brain Damage has to have a broken spine by now. That's it. There's no way he's going to be able to get up and walk after this.
Necro Butcher pouring blood profusely. Brain Damage somehow kicked out of that. Two of those metal folding chairs right to the center of the spine. This crowd's still in disarray. The action's finally got back into the ring now. Look at Necro Butcher's back from all the years of barbed wire death matches, from all the years of broken light tubes. This man is scarred from head to toe. Brain Damage now getting back up. I don't know what he's doing here. Picking him up with a chair on his back. Big scoop slammed.
Damn.
Tell you what, It's a strategy. Even though you wouldn't think there would be a strategy in a match like this, he's working on that back. If your back is broken too, you're not kicking out of a pin. He needs to go for the cover. This could be it. This could be it. Wait a minute. What do we have here? That thing is laced in barbed wire. Somebody ripped the pin coop door off the chicken house. Oh my God, he just sacrificed himself. Barbed wire stuck to brain damage. Just ripped inside of his chest, Nick.
No, I think the Necro Butcher got the worst of that, I think.
He went bare back on barbed wire. He sacrificed his own body to try to do damage to brain damage. Listen to the crowd. The crowd chanting crazy MCW. I'm telling you, fans, when MCW is in your town, you need to get there and buy a ticket. You never know what you're going to see. This is the best in the Midwest, in all the Midwest of wrestling. As we've said before, the future stars of tomorrow, today, and in the ring tonight, you've got two hardcore icons going at it. Once again, Necro Butcher picking brain damage up. He's getting cut off here. Brain damage working him over. Oh my God, are we gonna see a snap there? No! Oh my God, he just stunned him right trachea first into those chairs.
He had to have broke his throat. How is he supposed to breathe, Shasta?
Big boot to the side of the face. Necro Butcher now, you know, his trachea's gotta be crushed. You know what? You crush my spine, I crush your trachea. That's the way tonight's gonna go. Brain damage now throwing. There's chairs, there's metal, there's barbed wire in the middle of the ring. Taking Necro Butcher way up high, big scoop slam down on it all. That might be it. One, two, only a two count. I was thinking though with that trachea deal there, that might have been it.
All right, now, here we go with all the crap talking that Brain Damage was doing, saying that he was supposed to be in the movie The Wrestler. Now, Brain Damage is going to get what he deserves here.
I'll tell you what, if he's going to get what he deserves, Necro Butcher better wake up from that coma he's in right now. He just got pile driven right into the canvas. He's near the ropes.
That's nothing.
One, two. Whoa, wait, is he grabbing the ropes? I couldn't tell there. Referee Earl Robinson's still making the count. Telling Brain Damage only two. He can't believe it. He just cradle pile drove him right there into the ring. Necro Butcher doesn't even know what state he's in right now.
But he still had enough sense to put his foot on the bottom rope.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think he had enough sense. I think it was just knee-jerk reaction, literally. You cut a chicken's head off. Small package! Are you kidding me? Two! A small package? I can't believe that. We just saw a wrestling maneuver in the ring tonight. As I was saying before, when you cut a chicken's head off, it'll flop around for a while. That's just instinct right now he's moving in on. Shooting a man into the ropes. Big clothesline by Brain Damage. My money's on Brain Damage tonight, Nick.
My money's on the Necro Butcher. He has been a scary force in the hardcore scene for a long, long time.
Wait a minute now. Oh, my goodness. Did you hear that chair shot? That's a little receipt, a.k.a. payback for earlier when he took Brain Damage and slammed him right across spine first with those chairs to... Necro Butcher doesn't know where he's at. He's out on his feet, like a boxer is. There's times when boxers are just fighting on pure instinct. Necro Butcher is knocked out right now. Brain Damage setting up this chair. This isn't gonna be pretty. This is not gonna be pretty.
Necro Butcher still has life in him, Shasta. No matter how much punishment he takes, he still keeps going after Brain Damage.
Oh my goodness, if he hits this, this will be over with. He's up there. He's looking for the crowd. Here he goes. Oh, my God. Double head right into the chair. That's got to be it. Two, three. He wins it. He wins it, Nick. The crowd here is going crazy. There's carnage all over the place. Necro Butcher's neck may be broken.
It just may be. That move was one of the most disgusting things I've ever seen.
Look at that chair in the ring. Look at that chair right now. That chair is bent in half. My God, what a main event. You know what? I don't care what anybody says. These two men went out there tonight, put their bodies on the line. Once again, your winner, Brain Damage. I want to go take another look at that. Brain Damage telling the referee he can't even stand up. Let's go take another look at that finish as we go right now. There you go. Necro Butcher's head laying on the chair. Brain Damage asking the crowd to get up. He's jumping off.
Thank you.
knee first, right across the head. There you have it for the 1-2-3. Brain Damage is your winner. He's asking the crowd to get up, get behind him here. I think this score's been settled.
There it is, you fans. We told you, we promised you, we showed you. Here at Riot Television, we're going to bring you things that you're not going to see on any other wrestling program. We don't think that we're going to ever compete with them on a national level, but we can bring you something each and every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. that the other people are afraid to do, and that's what we are. We're an alternative to professional wrestling. We are showing you the future stars of tomorrow, today, and you just saw an icon in hardcore and Brain Damage facing off against Necro Butcher, a man who's been on a movie that was up for an Academy Award. The wrestler fell short. Brain Damage, knees to the head and chair equals victory. Nick, what did you see?
Actually, it's not really what I saw, because I mean, I did see a lot, but it's what I heard. Those sick thuds of those punches echoing through the WrestlePlex.
You know, I tell you what, people sometimes debate on whether wrestling is fake or real, and there is no way in hell you can convince me or anybody that when two men are sitting there punching each other in the face, 2 feet away from the audience members, there's no pulling back anything there. They were going at it. Those men right there may respect each other after a match like that, but they gave those fans every dime's worth of their money. And that's one thing that MCW is always gonna do. We're gonna bring you fans. We're gonna bring you part of, make you part of the action, make you part of the event where, you know, you're not paying $50 to sit in the nosebleed. You're paying a minimum price to sit on the front row and see carnage like that. We saw crutches flying across the arena. You know, it's almost like we need to have the audience members sign waivers to sit in at the show. There was blood pouring galore, and I'm telling you what right now, again, I don't know that you could really claim a victor in that match. Sure, Brain Damage got the pin, but he was pouring blood from, you know, two, three minutes into the match. The guy's losing gallons of blood, Nick.
Yeah, just because you get your hand raised in victory in that kind of a match does not mean you won.
So,
because the next day you're going to be feeling it. The next day, the day after that, the day after that, the day after that.
Absolutely. So when you fans see MCW come to your town, and if you ever hear us advertising a Fans Brain Weapons match, well, now you just got to see what those fans got to be a part of.
For the first time ever on television that
I
can ever
think of. As far
as I
know, yeah. No special DVD by there. We brought that to you live from our vault from the 11-year anniversary show. But you know what? Coming up next week, you think, well, wow, they had a ladder match debut episode. They had a Fans Bring Weapons match this episode. What are they going to do to top that? We're going to dial it back a little bit. But when we dial it back a little bit, we're going to up the stardom a little bit. You've watched this man as part of the WWE Tag Team Champions for years. Next week, right here, MCW Riot Television, the one, the only, Matt Hardy is going to be in action against one of MCW stars, superstar Bill Martel and Murder, Inc. You know what? That was a great matchup. You're going to get to see stars like Matt Hardy, Tommy Dreamer, Carlito. The list goes on and on. Over the next few months, the stars that came here to compete in MCW are long listed. And so you be ready next week, right back here, 9 p.m., WIVM, Tough TV Network. Matt Hardy is at MCW. Nick's going to be a hell of a show.
Absolutely, Shasta. That's it. We're going to wrap it up. We'll catch you next week, Wednesday, 9 o'clock, right here. I'm Nick Andrews. That's Shasta. Good night.
See you.